Solar collectors contain glazing materials, flow tubes, and absorber plates. Today we'll demonstrate how an 8-foot long absorber plate may be constructed. As you know, absorber plates absorb light energy and change it into heat. They also transfer that heat into flow tubes, where it may be transported into a storage system. Dozens of radiant floor heating fins may be used to build a collector absorber plate. An alternative to using individual heat fins involves the construction of a continuous absorber plate with multiple bends. To build an absorber plate with multiple bends, we must first build an absorber plate jig.
Okay, we've built our collector frame, we've installed our collector backing, we've installed the insulation, we also made our flow tube. What's next? Well, any ideas? That's right! The absorber plate. We have to make the absorber plate. So, before we make the absorber plate, we need to make the absorber plate jig. Some people call this the pounding jig, because we're going to use this jig to pound notches in this sheet of aluminum. This is actually aluminum flashing. It's a roll 50 feet long, 20 inches wide. So we'll be making, for each collector, it'll take two sheets. This is 3/8 inch inside diameter. So the outside diameter of this is a half inch, so you might think we should be using a half inch steel pounding rod, but actually it's better if we use something smaller. So I'm going to be using 3/8 inch pounding rods, and then when the aluminum pops out of the groove, it should expand to approximately a half inch. Anyway, that's the idea. Okay, so we'll be screwing these planks in here, and these planks are they're 1x6 planks. And the width of the planks is actually very critical. Remember, the aluminum is 20 inches wide. Now, if we made this 20 inches wide and we put the aluminum in, we'd have a hard time getting the aluminum out. It would just be a very tight fit. So we're making it slightly wider than 20 inches. It's 20 and an eighth inches wide. Our absorber plate jig is finished. Ta-da! Now all we have to do is pound some grooves in a sheet of aluminum. That's why some people call it the pounding jig. Now you can see some of the tools that we'll be using to pound it. And then there are six steel rods, 3/8 of an inch, and we have I call this a small sledgehammer. I'm sure there are better names for it. And we have some snips to cut the aluminum, and we also have some square rods, and the square rods will be used to pound the 3/8 inch rods a little deeper, and you'll see what I mean by that in just a moment. All right, but the first thing that we'll have to do is cut a piece of aluminum. This is our aluminum up here. This is a 50 foot roll of aluminum. When we pound grooves in this, the grooves are going to take up some space. So if we cut the aluminum 8 foot to fit inside our 8 foot long collector, the resulting absorber plate will be too short. So we have to make it longer than 8 foot. Now, I don't know exactly how much longer, because I haven't done this in a while. So for our first sheet, I'm going to cut a piece that's about 10 feet long. The actual length that we'll need will probably be 9 feet, or maybe a little more than 9 feet. I'll tell you what, let's take a chance. We'll make our first sheet 9.5 feet long. How's that?
Now the aluminum flashing
that will be used for the absorber plate is 20 inches wide, approximately. Actually, it's a little, this particular one is a little less, so I had to make a few adjustments. And if you look at the jig, you'll see these supports on the side. And these are guides, and these basically are, they're just used to hold the aluminum in place. So let's let our aluminum go. Okay, and now we're ready to pound some grooves in it. This is a kneeling board, and you'll see why that's important. So we have all these slots. The first thing you want to do is take your 3/8 inch steel rods and just put them in the slots. And this will loosely hold the aluminum in place when you're pounding it. And these guides prevent the aluminum from shifting too much from side to side. Remember, our collector will be 8 feet long, so we want our absorber plate to also be 8 feet long. So what could we do?
I don't know. You tell me. That's right.
We can rotate this absorber plate. So this fixture is only about 3.5 feet long. Make a longer fixture and just go down in one shot. But then you have a problem of storage. You don't really need a fixture 8 feet long. What you do need is you have to secure the first one just like you did before. As long as that's secure, then the only section that's going to I know it must look a little brutal, but I don't know if you have an idea, a better way of doing it, you let me know.
This is the back of our absorber plate, and we're almost ready to install it in our collector. But we need to do one more thing before we install it. One more thing. What we want to do is we're going to add a little insulation. Now the insulation has insulating value, but the main reason we're putting this insulation on is to support the bend, because we're going to be pressing the copper tube into these bends here. Okay, so on the back we're going to put insulation. Anyway, so that's all there is to it. I don't have to go through a blow-by-blow description of every single piece that I put on. I just wanted to show you this is one way. So this is one side, the other side will just have one of these squares.
I'm walking, here's the knee and I'm talking. And you and me, I'm hoping that you come back to me. I'm lonely as I can be. I'm waiting for your company. I'm hoping that you come back to me. What you gonna do in a well run dry? I'm gonna run right by your side. For you, pretty baby, I even die. I'm walking, yes indeed, I'm talking. But you and me, I'm hoping that you come back to me. Thank you. All you're gonna do is dry your wire. I'm walking, hear the deed I'm talking. By you and me, I'm hoping that you'll come back to me.